Greetings and welcome to an LGR thing, and this thing right here is the OPL2LPT. I bought one of these recently because it does something I have always dreamed about, and yes, I do dream of these things, and that is it provides a proper sound card that is not only using the parallel port, but is ad-lib compatible at an affordable price, especially compared to a full-sized original ad-lib card. But yeah, this really takes it a step beyond by going with the parallel port. Ugh, what I would have done for one of these back in the day. On a retro MS-DOS machine with only a PC speaker, having AdLib support is a notable upgrade. But yeah, the OPL2LPT is built and sold by Serdashop in Belgium, the same folks responsible for the excellent Dream Blaster daughter boards and the CVX4 Kovox speech thing clone, among other things. And it is currently available for 30 euros for a kit you assemble yourself, or 50 euros for an assembled and tested unit for a limited time. I bought the pre-assembled one because I'm lazy and I wanted a plug-and-play solution, much like the Kovox speech thing. In fact, you might be thinking that the OPL2LPT is similar to the Kovox and the Disney Sound Source, which I have covered here in the past. And that's true, but instead of only working with software that specifically supports it, this provides the much more common ad-lib compatible standard used in thousands of DOS games. And this is not just emulating it or imitating it in any way, this is the legit way of doing it. It features an original Yamaha YM3812 OPL2 sound chip. Ah, the same as the AdLib and the original Sound Blasters back in the day. And this is quite important to me considering I'm personally quite picky about how I like my FM synths to sound. And while I would have preferred the later OPL3, I'm happy with the 2 in this case, and there's a chance of an updated version with an OPL3 in the future. As for the rest of the board, you get the expected male parallel port connector, as well as a mini USB cable spot for power, and a 3.5mm audio jack for sound output. And there's a little volume knob on the end, just like you'd get on an original AdLib card from 1987. There's also a tiny reset button nestled in there in case things go weird, as well as a jumper that can be shorted to increase the bass output on the OPL2. Setting it up is straightforward, as you might expect. You just plug it into a free 25-pin parallel port, plug in the audio cable to your speakers or whatever, then power it via USB, which is one of the more irksome pieces of the device. The PCs that I want to use this on do not have a free USB port, so I had to plug mine into an adapter into the wall. And apparently you can also use a USB to PS2 adapter and plug it into the PS2 port, but that again doesn't work if you have that port filled up. Still, even with the extra cables dangling all over the place, this is absolutely ideal for, say, laptops that lack a built-in sound chip of any kind, or even those of us who want a proper OPL2 chip on a desktop with something inferior installed already, or you just have limited slots and you don't want to fill it up with something else. I just have a bunch of tiny desktops and laptops and stuff that this is ideal for. This is great. Now, seeing that this isn't exactly working in the same way as an original AdLib would, I mean, that didn't require any drivers or really setup of any kind, this does need a little bit more to get it going with your games. One program provided to do this is called AdLib, a TSR that lets your computer know there's an AdLib device present on the printer port, just like there's an AdLib installed. But this runs into problems with protected mode games, and it also requires a 386 CPU or better. So running it on an IBM PC, XT, or AT is pretty much out of the question. And even running on a 100 MHz 46DX4 here, I ran into some audio slowdown and gameplay stuttering, so it's not ideal. So short of running it on a much faster machine, in that case you'd want to use AdPatch, which patches games directly to specifically look for the OPL2LPT and also run smoother while supporting sub-386 CPUs. The downside is that it only supports a handful of games right now, and sadly this means that games like Duke Nukem 3D don't yet work with the OPL2LPT at all. But for the games that do work with it, dude, this thing does its job wonderfully. Despite the slowdowns here and there on certain hardware, the OPL2 sound is dead on, as it should be. And the fact that it's working over freaking parallel just amuses me endlessly. So with all that being said, here is the reward, the payoff. Enjoy some lovely AdLib sound samples. Thank you. yeah, that's pretty much it for what I want to show of the OPL2 LPT. I hope that gives you a good idea of what it can and cannot do. Such as with Doom there, you might have noticed that the sound effects were not playing. That's because Doom uses digital PCM sound effects and the ad-lib does not generate those, it's only an FM synth. Now some games will modulate this and play PCMs through ad-lib, but most often that is not the case. So unless the game does ad-lib sound, you're pretty much just going to get music through this. And that's just normal for an OPL2 ad-lib compatible. Again, the real downsides here are, if you're running it on a slower system, then the games are probably going to slow down here and there and have some stuttering issues. But even on a faster system with a Pentium or Pentium 2 or beyond, there's still plenty of times, especially with games after 1992 or 93 or so, where it just will not work. A lot of my favorites don't give sound at all. Games like Duke Nukem 3D, SimCity 2000, even games like Wacky Wheels, it just doesn't see that there's an FM synth there whatsoever. But really, if the alternative is having no FM synth at all on the particular computer that I might want to use this on, then, well, here you go. For those ideal situations, this is pretty ideal. And support for other games will pretty much only improve over time as the TSR improves and ad patch gets more support. And that is awesome. The OPL2 LPT gets the LGR seal of approval.